Hello. In today's video, we shall learn in detail about fungus Ericife. By the end of this video, you'll have a clear understanding about its mode of reproduction and its life cycle pattern. Let us start with the introduction to Ericifales. Ericifales are an order of Ascomycetes fungi. The order includes obligate ectophytic parasites, which usually grow on the surface of the host plant. The order contains only one family, Ericifaceae, which comprises of several species. Chief among them are Ericife, Podosphaera, Microsphaera. Many of the Ericifales cause plant disease called powdery mildew. Genus Ericife infects a large number of species of angiosperms, particularly the grains or cereals. Ericifales have superficial mycelium, which extracts nourishment from the host plant through specialized hyphae. These hyphae form haustoria and penetrate the epidermal cells of the host plant. Asexual spores, conidia, are produced in abundance on the shoot of the infected host plants, giving them a whitish powdery appearance. The order Ericifales have Cleistothecium type of ascocarp, and the asci are scattered in the young Cleistothecium. Mature Cleistothecium of Ericifales has the asci arranged parallel to one another, forming a well-defined hymenium at the base of the Cleistothecial cavity. Let us take Ericife as a type to illustrate the pattern of life cycle. It is a genus of fungi in the family Ericifaceae. Many species of this genus are plant pathogens which cause powdery mildew. They are obligate ectophytic parasites which infect a large number of species of angiosperms, particularly the grains or cereals. They occur in aerial parts, causing powdery mildew. Ericife polygony causes powdery mildew disease of peas. Ericife graminis causes powdery mildew of cereal crops such as wheat, barley. Ericife sicoraceum is the causal agent of powdery mildew of cucurbits. Mycelium of Ericife is superficial and grows over the surface of leaf or stem of the host plant. The mycelium has septate, hyaline hyphae, which form a web-like white covering on the host surface. The cells are short and uninucleate with vacuolated cytoplasm. It forms haustorial branches which penetrate the epidermal cells, and the tip of each haustorial branch swells to form the haustorium. It lies in the lumen of the epidermal cell, surrounded by the host cell protoplast. In Ericife graminis, the haustorium is complex in structure. It consists of an elongated central body with finger-like processes at either end. Dense matrix surrounds the outer face of the body region of the haustorium and extends around the finger-like processes. This sheath-like matrix is known as sheath matrix or extrahaustorial matrix. A thin extrahaustorial membrane or sheath membrane or the encapsulation membrane delimits the sheath matrix from the host cytoplasm. The sheath membrane is a derivative of the plasma membrane of the host cell. The haustorium is cut off from the supporting hypha by a septum and contains mitochondria. By the way, if you're getting some value out of this video, please like and share the video so that all of us can learn, unlearn, and relearn together. Also, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Let us understand asexual reproduction in genus Ericeif. Asexual reproduction, Ericeif, starts during the growing season. The fungal parasite produces asexual spores called conidia. They are produced in abundance exogenously in chains at the tip of the conidial apparatus. Several short hyphal branches grow vertically at right angles with the host surface. These are the conidiophore initials. Each conidiophore is short, upright, unbranched, and septate. The cell subtending the conidiophore initial is the foot cell. A cross wall appears in the apical region of the conidiophore initial, dividing it into a short terminal generative cell and a basal long stalk cell. In a fully developed conidial apparatus, the conidiophore cell contains a single nucleus with a few large vacuoles. It may also contain glycogen granules. The generative cell has dense cytoplasm, numerous ribosomes, small scattered vacuoles, and a single nucleus. The conidial apparatus consists of conidiophore, generative cell, and conidium initials. Next is development of conidia. The terminal generative cell cuts off the first conidium initial at its tip. It is followed by another division to produce second conidial initial below the first. Succession of conidia are formed and they cling together in upright chains and mature from the apex downwards. They are easily dispersed by wind. The disease spreads in summer by the conidia. The conidia of Ericeif germinate immediately on falling on a suitable host. They germinate over a range of temperature, optimum range 12 to 25 degrees Celsius. Neither free water nor high relative humidity is necessary for germination. Each conidium germinates by forming 1 to 3 germ tubes, which give rise to new mycelium. The germ tube, when it comes in contact with the host cuticle, forms an epressorium, which gives rise to the haustorium within the epidermal cell. Next, let us learn about the sexual reproduction in Ericeif. Sexual reproduction occurs in summer. Almost all species are homothallic. In Ericeif polygony, sex organs antheridium and ascogonium arise in pairs near each other from the somatic mycelium. The nucleus of the male branch divides into two and are separated by a septum. The terminal uninucleate cell functions as the antheridium and the lower supporting cell as the stalk cell. The female branch consists of a terminal uninucleate club-shaped ascogonium and a basal stalk cell. Next is plasmogamy. The antheridium and ascogonium come in close contact with each other at the apex. The wall between them breaks and a pore is formed through which the male nucleus reaches the ascogonium. A dikaryon is formed in the ascogonium. From the stalk cell, sterile hyphae grow and form a sheath or peritium around the ascogonium. Post-plasmogamy changes are clearly seen. The dikaryotized ascogonium divides, forming few cells. Penultimate cell contains two or more nuclei. From this, cell mass of ascogenous hyphae are formed, which develop within the peritium. Binucleate, intercalary cells of the ascogenous branches function as ascus mother cells. A synkaryon is formed when the two nuclei in the ascus mother cell fuse. The synkaryon first undergoes meiosis, followed by mitosis to form 8 haploid nuclei. This is known as octonucleate stage in the development of an ascus. In spring, the asci in the cleistothecium mature and produce ascospores. Next is the cleistothecium type of ascocarp. Cleistothecia are round structures without an opening and are seen as black specks on the surface of white mycelium. The peritium or sheath around the cleistothecium is several cells in thickness. Certain cells of the peritium develop into long, unbranched hyphae. All the asci arise from the base of the cleistothecial cavity. The shape of asci and the number of ascospores vary from species to species. Let us look into the mechanism of dehiscence of cleistothecium. The peritium helps the cleistothecium to resist adverse conditions. In spring season, the asci absorb water and swell, resulting in the rupture of the upper portion of the peritium. The asci are exposed, they burst, and ascospores are released and easily dispersed by wind. The ascospores germinate immediately when they come in contact with the host plant and infect it by forming new mycelium. So today we have learnt about fungus Erysiphe in detail, especially about its mode of reproduction and its pattern of life cycle. Thank you so much for your time and participation. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please consider subscribing the channel and press the bell icon to get instant notification of all the upcoming videos. Also, if you want to discuss any particular topic in biology, please mention that in the comments section below. I'll see you there. Goodbye. All the best.